Both players having taken some time to think out their game plan. Both think it's going to be a very even matchup here. And really, this first turn, you know, Emilio running that Mega Gengar team going to be so important not to fall behind early.
Yeah, this turn one is going to be incredibly important here. Emilio has led Gengar nearly throughout the entire course of the tournament, and he does have this Parasong capability. So once again, we do see the Gengar here. Not too much of a surprise, but once that Gengar Mega evolves and potentially sets up a Parasong, you're trapped in for three turns. And so Paul knows that he has to play around that these next couple of turns, and his lead is definitely a pretty strong one here to counter it right from the get-go.
Absolutely. Paul Ruiz leading that Gastrodon and Salamence. Emilio, when we spoke to him before the match, said that that Gastrodon was going to be the biggest threat on Paul's team, and it's right there on turn one, threatening both the Landorus and the Gengar.
Landorus here really not able to do too much damage-wise. It can potentially threaten the Gastrodon with a Z move, but of course the Salamence did intimidate it, so I think likely here we're going to want to see it maybe go for a U-turn or switch out. Gengar here is actually really threatened immediately by the potential Z move from that Gastrodon, but of course Emilio probably brought the Tapu Bulu in this game to counter the Gastrodon. Wouldn't be too surprised to see it come in here, but it's actually going to be Incineroar to cycle out a Fake Out.
Yeah, just double intimidates off onto that Salamence as well, but Incineroar able to exert some Fake Out pressure against Paul's Pokemon, and a big deal for stalling turns of Parish Song, getting those free turns as much as possible. Mega Salamence is the choice from Paul's side. Going to go ahead and boost up the power of Salamence, get that Aerialate ability to make sure that it can hit for flying type damage in the future should that Tapu Bulu come out. Mega Gengar on the field immediately from Emilio, trapping in the Gastrodon and Salamence. And Paul Ruiz going ahead and neutralizing one of those Intimidates on the Salamence with the Dragon Dance, boosting its speed, boosting its attack. Gengar sets up a substitute, though, going to be protected from an attack from Paul. And it looks like Gastrodon's just going to go right ahead with a Z Crystal boosted attack here. If that's into the substitute, that's bad news for Paul.
Yeah, he'll at least be able to break the substitute, but that's not why you want to commit this early on in the game. So let's see who it targets. If he called the Incineroar switch in, it would have been incredible, but I think still okay here. At least you now break the substitute and your Salamence is guaranteed to be faster than a Gengar. But like you mentioned, the Cycle Wave intimidates. I think that's one thing that's really difficult for Paul's team to deal with here. He only has two special attackers. It's likely he does have that Tapu Koko in the back, but now Emilio has a trap in, so he can continue cycling the Landorus back in and out. Gengar, however, on the other hand, does have a pretty low defense stat. So even with the Intimidate, Salamence can still hit for pretty hard, but now that Incineroar is in, you can go for a potential Fake Out. However, Gengar has to worry about attacks from both Gastrodon and Salamence right
now. Yeah, really difficult to pick which Pokemon you want to Fake Out this turn. If you're Emilio, go straight for the Gastrodon. Salamence showing double edge with that boost.
How much does it do?
Oh, it's enough! Picks it up!
Out.
Paul Ruiz has broken the trap. Mega Gengar goes down, Salamence takes damage from the recoil, and Gastrodon flinching from that Fake Out, but huge threat off the field on Emilio's side. Mega Gengar not able to set the trap, not able to set the Parish Song. Gonna need this Latias to do some work in this game to make up for that Mega Gengar.
What an incredible game plan Paul came with in this set. I thought Gengar was easily the most important Pokemon on Emilio's team, and he's able to get it right out of the field immediately. Despite the attack drops in Salamence, Salamence really strong physically, and Gengar really frail defensively, still gets knocked out there, and that's a big knockout for Paul. We do see the Latias come out, does threaten the Salamence with something like an Ice Beam, but this Gastrodon is going to be even harder to deal with now because there is no Tapu Bulu in the back.
Yeah, no Tapu Bulu, which means that Gastrodon gets to go up against a Latias, an Incineroar, and a Landorus. Loves that matchup. Incineroar switching out for the Mega Salamence. Paul will be protecting that Pokemon on his side. Gets the Intimidate off onto Emilio's Incineroar as well and sets up Fake Out pressure for himself in the next turn.
Did he
Landorus on the switch in. Both Pokemon on Emilio's side. Super weak to this Gastrodon, hoping to bait out an Earth Power from the Gastrodon. And it's an Ice Beam from the Latias. Gonna deal some damage to that Incineroar. Very little bit of damage. And it's an Ice Beam from Gastrodon!
That's an Ice Beam! That's it!
Oh, the Landorus! Gastrodon! Free damage on that Landorus! 4x super effective, hanging on with just a sliver of health there. Paul Ruiz Yo, he's here for the championship. He does not want to go home a runner-up.
That was a nice beam, but that play was fiery hot right there. Almost knocking out the Landers, but still such an incredible play. Ice beaming and Incineroar calling the switch out. And if you're able to make those plays with the Gastron like that, this Gastron is already really difficult to deal with. And he was able to bring in the Incineroar to psycho out for fake out pressure. This Latios really doesn't do anything against Incineroar. Can maybe go for a psychic type attack onto the Gastron, but this is really tricky here. I mean, Paul could fake out the Landers relatively free and get a switch in here. As we will do so.
Yeah, switching in the Snorlax, Emilio does have the option of using that Psycheon Z on his Latios for some big damage, but instead just going to go for the Protect this turn, does not want to get faked out on either of his Pokemon. Double Protect coming out, so Snorlax gets in for absolutely free. Incineroar just going to with that fake out into the Landorus Protect, but Paul Ruiz has set up a position where he now has that Snorlax out, able to tank damage from both the Landorus and the Latias pretty easily.
Yeah, this Snorlax is a tricky Pokemon to bring into this matchup because of the Gengar. It can't really touch the Gengar as it doesn't actually have high horsepower, but now that the Gengar's out the way, it doesn't even need a setup. It can just go for attacks. You know, Landorus is already so low as is, and we're going to see Incineroar switch out to Psycho and Intimidate back in. Also, you want to conserve that for an end game potentially against the Latias.
Yeah, absolutely, and that Gastrodon is already exerting so much pressure on both of Emilio's Pokemon. Will take an Ice Beam from the Latias on the switch, but Gastrodon is pretty bulky here. Looks like we are going to see another Tectonic Rage coming out this time from Emilio's Landorus. Would be big if it hit the Gastrodon on the switch, but Snorlax protecting will be able to defend against most of the damage.
Yeah, that's a great turn for Paul there once again. Does guard the Gastrodon, but I think Paul doesn't mind this turn too much because now you know that there is no immediate threat to the Snorlax. No Z-move pressure from either Pokemon. Gastrodon will go down, but it has done its work in this game. I mean, being able to get that Ice Beam while putting on so much pressure. More importantly, now the Snorlax is so much more difficult to deal with. I think both Snorlax and Gastrodon major threats from Paul's team, especially if you eliminate the Gengar and don't have to worry about Tapu Bulu. Now, the Intimidate comes against the Landorus. Latios is even less useful here, and Snorlax puts on immense pressure against both Pokemon. Could considering setting up, but maybe you just go for damage at this point.
Yeah, you have Incineroar out on the field with Fake Out pressure. Pretty easy to get a Belly Drum off here if you're Paul Ruiz, but yeah, like you mentioned, may just be best to go for immediate damage. Catch Pokemon like this Incineroar on the switch-in. The Intimidate will be hitting both Paul Ruiz's Incineroar and the Snorlax, dropping their attack a single stage, making the switch-in a little bit safer. Fake Out will come out from Paul onto the Latias, so no damage coming out
from
Emilio, and a free Belly Drum, absolutely free Belly Drum from that Snorlax. Going to go ahead and maximize its attack, negating the Intimidate entirely and healing all the way up with its Gluttony ability, eating that berry at 50%. Healing all the way back up, and that is an angry Snorlax on the field.
Yeah, Paul has really positioned the Snorlax into a perfect position, actually, where we actually know it has Recycle as well, so it could heal back even later on in the game, but Latias and Incineroar right now can't really put on, once again, too much pressure in terms of damage, and Snorlax is just going to take a turn here to blow a potential fake out.
Yeah, Snorlax just going to go ahead and protect this turn so it does not get faked out. Emilio predicting that protect will go ahead and just try and get the fake out onto Incineroar to prevent Paul from making any moves of his own. But now we are in a position where Snorlax cannot be faked out. It will be able to get a frustration off, and Emilio no longer has that Gengar to wall this Snorlax, so whatever switches in is going to take a beating.
Yeah, with the double protect now, Paul is free to target either of these two Pokemon. Emilio has to hope for an Ice Beam freeze here on Snorlax if he wants any chance. And does he get the freeze here? Doesn't do very much damage and no freeze.
No, no freeze, and a Snarl coming out from Paul Ruiz's Incineroar will drop the special attack of that Latias, making Latias so much less threatening, especially if it ends up being the only Pokemon left unable to switch out. But Paul's just going to play this one safe, play it a little slow, recover up that berry, and make sure that it can survive some more hits coming later. As Emilio switches Incineroar out for Landorus, cycling those Intimidates, but it's going to take a lot of cycling to get that Snorlax back into a reasonable position.
Yeah, you know, you're pretty much hoping for maybe an Earthquake critical hit here, but I'm not even sure that will knock out the Snorlax, and so the Recycle just
put
allows
it into a berry range.
Yeah, exactly. So Paul playing it safe here, and I think that's an excellent decision on his end. Also, the Snarl means that Latios damage output is basically negligible against Snorlax right now, so this Snorlax is looking like an absolute monster, being able to set up in the perfect position, and the reason why Paul was able to do this was because he eliminated that Gengar on the second turn of this game. So it feels like Paul really came here with a concise game plan and has been executing it perfectly. Let's see if we get a freeze from Ice Beam right now.
Yeah, no protect, just another Ice Beam onto Snorlax.
No
Not
freeze.
Enough to get the berry either, so this Earthquake will have an opportunity to crit on the Snorlax. Connects with both Incineroar and Snorlax, deals a lot of damage, gets the KO on Incineroar, but not on the Snorlax. Gets the crit, but on the wrong Pokemon. Snorlax is going to heal back up with the berry and fire off of frustration into Emilio's side.
Yeah, and that's definitely going to be a guaranteed knockout, presumably targeting down the Landers, but let's see.
Ooh, it's going to be the Latias.
Yeah, going to go for Latias, actually, just to probably avoid any potential freeze. Yeah.
And makes it much more safe for Salamence to come back in as the final Pokemon.
Absolutely. So I think either target there, honestly, a pretty good one. Ended up going for the Latias. Now you don't have to worry about the freeze chance, which I think is actually probably a bigger deal. Mm-hmm. Whereas with Landorus, now you have to worry maybe about Rock Slide flinches, but at least, like you mentioned, you do have the speed advantage completely here with Salamence.
All right, so no more switching out of Intimidates on Emilio's side. We'll have to be dealing with this plus four Snorlax. Does get the Intimidate off onto Salamence, but being able to just double protect away the fake out pressure, looks like Emilio wants to go directly into game two, realizing he has no outs here. And Paul Ruiz, just like that, is up 1-0 in the Masters World Championship Finals. One game away from bringing the trophy to Latin America, to Ecuador, and making history here in Nashville.
You really could tell that Paul came with a game plan in this one. I feel like bringing Snorlax into this matchup can be really tricky because you're bringing it against a Gengar, which you can't touch at all. But once that Gengar was gone, Paul was able to find the perfect position, the perfect turn to be able to set up that belly drum. Mm-hmm. Emilio opted not to bring that Tapu Bulu either, so it meant that it was almost impossible to deal with both Gastrodon and Snorlax at the same time. So going into this next game, I think Paul's lead was probably a little bit better than Emilio's from the start, and he was able to capitalize off that initial Dragon Dance, getting rid of that substitute, and then now knowing that, okay, Salamence, even at minus one attack, is still going to be able to knock out my Gengar with that Double Edge. I'm not sure Emilio was quite expecting that damage out. And you can tell Paul is living in it right now, hyping up that entire crowd.
Yeah, Paul is feeling the energy coming out from the crowd, and if you want Emilio to take home the championship, you're going to need to be sending him some energy as well, because he needs to win this game too. If he does not win, he will be ending his tournament, his Cinderella tournament here, as a runner-up. But if he wins, he can force a game three and keep those championship hopes alive.
Emilio here, I was kind of surprised to see the Landorus lead. I think I was expecting something like Incineroar and Gengar. Mm-hmm. But regardless, now what is important to know is that that Salamence is really, really strong. I think a Salamence Gastrodon, a really clever lead there. One way you could potentially threaten that a little bit more is maybe leading the Latias, because that does threaten the Salamence immediately with some damage output. You also actually threaten Gastrodon at least with some consistent psychic damage as well. So we'll see how Emilio adjusts here, because Paul came with a really good game plan in that first game.
All right, well, game two of our Masters Division Finals here. Emilio Forbes versus Paul Ruiz. We saw in turn one just how important the lead combination was. Paul able to snipe out that Gengar really early on, sticks with what he knows works, Salamence and Gastrodon. Emilio making the decision to switch up the leads just a little bit, still sticking with the Gengar lead, but bringing out the Latias this time to immediately threaten that Salamence.
I really like that adjustment by Emilio, and I think that's what he should have gone for now, because the threat of Latias means that Salamence cannot go for a necessarily free Dragon Dance. You have to be worried about the Ice Beam coming out immediately. So, great lead by Emilio here. I thought last time Paul had the advantage because turn one he was able to get a free Dragon Dance. This time around he doesn't have to worry about Intimidate, but the threat of Latias immediately definitely have to scare you off a little bit. Gastrodon, however, still threatens Gengar immensely, and Gengar doesn't provide too much damage against either of these Pokemon.
Yeah, and we know Latias not only threatens the Salamence, but also threatens that Gastrodon with the Psychium Z that it's holding, able to launch off a Shattered Psyche should it decide to just try and fire down that Gastrodon that really controlled the game for Paul. Looks like Paul's going to protect the Salamence and switch in the Snorlax in the face of that Gengar that we know Snorlax is unable to actually damage, only having frustration as an attack. So Emilio able to Mega Evolve Gengar now, trapping in the Gastrodon and the Snorlax, going for a Protect this time, not a Substitute. Latias also going to go for a Protect here, just trying to scout out what Paul was going to do. And it looks like going to bait out another of these Z-moves from the Gastrodon. This time not hitting into the Substitute, but will be hitting into a Protect.
Yeah, last time around it did hit into the Substitute, but what's more important is it actually does get chip damage enough where probably another Earth Power or that minus one Double Edge will knock out. So even though it's not the knockout that you might necessarily want, it's actually still a pretty good turn here where you do a lot of damage, and that does put the pressure on against Gengar. You see that that almost does have
almost
to
double.
Help.
Oh! A critical hit through the Protect, so dealing more damage than the Substitute last time around, but crucially, that Snorlax is now trapped in here with Gengar. At least Gengar and Latias both use their Protect, so no safe ability for Emilio to stick around with Gengar, set the trap, and continue to boost that way.
Ooh, just
gonna
damage.
Go on the attack, just damage, no Perish Song coming out. Deals a good amount to Gastrodon and gets the special defense drop, which is going to be huge for this Shattered Psyche coming out from Latias.
That should knock out the Gastrodon. This is presumably a double target there, especially after that special defense drop. But if Paul here is going for a belly drum, maybe it's actually not the end of the world. At least he does set up the Snorlax, and now that threatens everything on the Latias side. You know that Gengar is already the one Pokemon that can resist the normal type attack, so you can consistently target those returns into the Latias slot, and Gastrodon will go
there
down.
There it goes. Gastrodon goes down to the Shattered Psyche. Emilio takes the Pokemon lead in game one, but Paul will be able to go ahead and set up the belly drum on his Snorlax. And actually, the interesting part about having the Snorlax and the Mega Gengar out is they can't actually damage each other.
Right.
The only option for Gengar to get that Snorlax off the field is the Perish Song. So really going to have to see if Emilio is going to be able to play around that. But that KO means that Paul will be able to switch in the Incineroar, threatening potentially both the Mega Gengar and the Latias.
I think Incineroar definitely the correct Pokemon to bring out in this situation. If you bring out Salamence, you're at threat. If Latias protects, it can just Ice Beam you the next turn and you're trapped in. So there's some Protect Mind games. It feels like a 50-50 on whether you call it correctly or not. With Incineroar, you don't have to gamble as much about that. And now it does threaten, of course, the Gengar with damage. Even if it chooses to go for Substitute, we know that the Incineroar does have Snarl, and of course Snorlax can just now knock out that Latias slot. More importantly for Paul, the Z-move has now been committed, so it's really difficult to actually deal with this Snorlax, other than that Perish Song, as you mentioned. Interestingly enough, if we're in a situation where it's Gengar versus Snorlax one-on-one, Perish Song will actually lose Emilio the game because Paul's Snorlax is slower.
Well, Emilio is going to go ahead and retreat the Mega Gengar for his own Incineroar, getting Fake Out pressure on the field for himself and intimidates off onto both the enemy Incineroar and Snorlax. But again, when Belly Drum maxes out your attack, it's going to take a lot to get that back under control. Incineroar will use Flare Blitz into what was the Gengar, now the opposing Incineroar on Emilio's side, dealing a little bit of damage while Latias protects itself from this Snorlax's frustration.
Paul playing it safe this turn, ended up not going for something like a Recycle maybe to get the berry back, but I think perfectly reasonable play. Nice switch in there by Emilio actually to get that Intimidate off. Helps a little bit more against the Incineroar. Snorlax is still going to be getting knockouts, but now you do have the potential to get a Fake Out off. It's a relatively safe switch in there because it's highly unlikely Snorlax is going to target down that Gengar with a normal type attack. So.
Yeah.
A little bit of more momentum going into Emilio's favor. He made some really nice adjustments, and knocking out that Gastrodon earlier was a great play.
Yeah, and crucially, keeping that Mega Gengar around, which makes that Snorlax much less scary, always has the opportunity to switch the Gengar in to protect a Pokemon on Emilio's side. Actually, just going to switch the Latias out for the Landorus. Going to get Intimidates off again onto both of Paul's Pokemon. But leaving that slot open to an attack from the Snorlax. Double switch, so Mega Gengar will come back in here, protecting the Incineroar. Just going to go ahead and set the trap.
Goes for that wood hit.
Comes out again from Paul's Incineroar, deals a little bit of damage to Gengar, drops the special attack, meaning that Gengar is really not threatening anything but a Perish Song here.
Where's the frustration going? Oh, into the Gengar.
Emilio making the right call. Frustration into Gengar. And Snorlax probably feeling a little bit frustrated himself.
Yeah, double switch there definitely means that you are vulnerable to a potential knockout there immediately. So Emilio does call it correctly. Gengar still does take some damage, but now he's got the trap in. Incineroar's damage output really reduced. I mean, Snarl, however, is still going to chip away, but this Gengar is still healthy enough to probably survive. Definitely going to survive one. You're going to need to go for at least two here. And, you know, the Landorus, of course, putting on pressure with Earthquake. However, Snorlax is still sitting at plus four attack, so it still will easily knock out anything on the Landorus slot. I think this is definitely still a pretty even board position for both players.
We're basically in the same position as we were a couple of turns ago, last time Gengar was here. But with the Landorus out instead of the Latias, Emilio just trying to chip away at that attack stat with all of these Intimidates. Got it down to plus three now.
Yep.
Still pretty strong, but you know, getting a little bit weaker. Landorus will go ahead and U-turn out. So switching out, able to now switch the Gengar back in with that U-turn, protecting the Landorus for one more turn and making sure that Paul does not get any damage out. Has to be the Gengar in that slot. No other option. Can't risk switching in the Latias. So Paul, Incineroar does go for another Flare Blitz. This time it's going to target down the Incineroar a second time, dealing even less damage than it did the first time. And Snorlax is so frustrated. Emilio is just dancing around Paul right now with all these switches, these U-turns, and making solid use of Mega Gengar's immunity to the normal type frustration.
Yeah, it's not every day you see a Snorlax get intimidated so much to the point where maybe it actually won't be able to get those guaranteed knockouts, but really, really smart cycling here from Emilio thus far, and he's been able to negate so many attacks, and there's the Perish Song finally.
Finally gets the Perish Song off onto the Incineroar and the Snorlax. Incineroar does flinch. Snorlax will be able to fire off a frustration, this time actually connecting with the Pokemon.
Yes.
Finally connects with the Pokemon with that frustration, knocks out Incineroar, but now there is a timer on the field. Snorlax needs to get more Pokemon knockouts if it's going to be effective here.
Yeah, I genuinely was wondering, you know, at plus three, if you have like no attack investment in Snorlax, maybe you actually don't even knock out the Incineroar, but it does manage to pick up that knockout. But another Intimidate coming out, meaning that the Snorlax now is only a plus two attack. And
just a sword stance.
Yes, exactly. And with that Perish Song out on the field now, you are on a timer with both of these two Pokemon. I think if you manage to knock out both throughout the Perish Song, and Paul isn't able to take more than one knockout, the game is probably over. So Emilio has made some really incredible switches this game, and that specifically has really kept him in it, especially after a strong lead.
All right, Emilio's Landorus and Gengar. This is a super scary two Pokemon set to have out on the field if you're Paul Ruiz. Gengar free to switch out to protect, or just protect to stall the Perish Song, while Landorus can U-turn all over the place, all kinds of shenanigans. Emilio just going to start the double protects up so he can start counting down those Perish Song turns. And the Snarl's going into nothing. And Snorlax, his frustration, also into nothing.
This next turn is going to be really huge. I think it's more or less actually going to decide this game specifically here, because there's so much going on right now, right? You know both Pokemon protected, so you know you can freely target potentially both. So the Gengar here, of course, if the Landorus gets knocked out, if the Gengar still remains in, then it's actually going to faint to its own Perish Song. So you'd imagine maybe Gengar wants to switch out, but if it does, the Snorlax can call that and just target that slot with the frustration.
And so many switch shenanigans are possible with both the option of switching out Gengar, U-turning Landorus to bring the Gengar back in. It's kind of like a janky ally switch.
Yeah, exactly. And the other question I got to ask is, you know, is Snorlax at plus two going to be able to knock out that Landorus? We see Substitute here.
Substitute coming out from Gengar will be protected from an attack. Landorus's U-turn into the Incineroar deals a lot of damage with a critical hit. But that Substitute is going to protect the Gengar from a lot of types of damage.
But not the Snorlax!
Latias is the switch in front of the Incineroar, and
there's a Snorlax!
The Snorlax comes through!
The Substitute!
Goes through the Substitute, sound attacks not affecting the Substitute, knocks out the Mega Gengar, gets some damage on the Latias, gets a special defense or special attack drop, and the frustration finally coming out. All of that.
That's a knockout! Paul Ruiz can taste the World Championship! What an incredible play there, he gets it! It's exactly what he needed to do there, and you know, with the option of Snarl actually going through Substitute, that saved Paul the game there. If it didn't, then a Gengar gets an extra turn there and the Perish Trap most likely goes down and Paul loses both of his Pokemon. But perfect play there by Paul to get a double knockout. And despite all the Intimidates, despite all these switches by Emilio, Paul Ruiz is now one turn away from winning this World Championship, and he must be able to taste it. So incredibly well played despite Emilio's switches.
Paul Ruiz has given up so much this year for a taste at the championship. He knew all along semifinals weren't enough. He wanted to bring home the cup, bring home the championship title back to Latin America for the first time in the video game championships. Intimidate from Salamence will make sure that Landorus not able to do much of anything at all. The Perish Song finally getting the KO onto Snorlax, and a second Intimidate coming in from the Incineroar that switched out. Landorus now at minus two attack. facing down Salamence and Incineroar with fake out pressure and a protect that was just used.
All you need to do is click fake out, go for a Dragon Dance, that Salamence will be able to knock out the Landers. You can see the emotion in Paul's face, but I gotta say, wow, this second game was so exciting where I felt like Emilio made some really incredible adjustments and it felt like he had Paul's number for multiple turns with all those switches, but that's the thing, right? Once a Snorlax sets up, it's still, even with all these Intimidates, gonna be able to do so much damage.
Oh, no double protect.
There's the fake out coming out, most likely a Dragon Dance from the Salamence as we do see, and that effectively should seal up the game. So incredibly played here by Paul, and I think he came with a masterful game plan, right? He ended up bringing Snorlax into
the set. There it is.
And wow.
There it is. Emilio going to go ahead and forfeit this match and wake up, world, because Paul Ruiz is your first ever Latin American world champion representing his country.